Hi, welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. We're in the studio again doing politics schmolitics because we've got elections coming up, which in fact are in a very short while will be deciding whether there will be a new government. And in the throes of this whole decision making, we had a forum last night put on by unChain Inc. And the fellow who organised it all is right here in the studio with me, Serge Thomann.
Henry, what a pleasure to be here.
Well, it's been a long time.
I've never been here.
I know.
I was longing for that information.
I know.
Invitation, sorry.
So you've now got an invitation. You're in the studio. You're involved with unChain, very much so.
But I started unChain. I was the first president of unChain. Then when I got elected to council, I resigned my position. But obviously, I'm still a member of unChain, and after the and I got back onto the executive committee after the elections, yes.
Right. And you were the deputy mayor of the city of Port Phillip for a while?
Yes, I was 5 years councillor and 3 years deputy mayor, yes.
And now you're no longer on the council?
I was turfed out.
What a relief.
Well, not really, but the thing is that obviously the Port Phillip council now is full of politicians, you know, seven out of the nine are member of a party.
Really?
In my time, there were only a couple. And I think council should be full of people who are interested in local communities and local outcomes and not just basically running for, you know, out of the six or seven of the current councils have either run for an election or run for a press election. So is that the role of a councillor? You know, I don't believe it should be the stamping block for another career.
So unChain was formed as part of the triangle?
Correct. unChain was formed to stop the massive development on the triangle side, yes.
And nothing has happened since then?
But we stopped what was approved, so that's a good start. So I don't mind if it's still a car park for a while. You know, it makes a lot of money for the council. But the massive development that we were against did not eventuate because we stopped it. But the palais has been refurbished. One of the reasons why this massive development was supposed to happen was to pay for the refurbishment of the palais, because the owner of the palais, being the crown land and being the state government, that they didn't want to pay for the refurbishment. But Martin Foley, as part of his election commitment 5 years ago, said he would put in the money, and council put in some money, and the palais is all refurbished.
Fantastic. Last night we went to a forum which was held at Memo Hall.
Yes.
And you organised all that.
Correct, yes. On behalf of unChain, yes.
And I was there filming it. So we're going to show some grabs of the three main candidates for the seat of Macnamara.
Yes. And the thing you said, we talked about a change of government. We don't obviously we don't know if there will be a change of government. But one thing we know is that there is a change of member of parliament for the area. As the retiring member is no longer standing. So we know that the new member is a new member. So,
correct. And a new name.
And a new name named after a nurse.
That's right.
From back quite a while ago. So it's a woman nurse being recognised, which I think is a good thing. It makes more sense than Melbourne Ports. I have to say, either the Australian Electoral Commission or the Victorian Electoral Commission are not very creative when it comes to names, because for the city of Port Phillip, you've got the Lake Ward, and the Canal Ward, and the Gateway Ward. You know,
no, they're not very creative at all. But you created an event last night, which I was very impressed with, where we had the three main candidates. We had Josh Burns, who's taking over from Michael Danby as the Labor candidate.
Correct.
And we had Kate Ashmor from the Liberals.
Correct.
And we also had Steph Hodgins-May
yes.
from the Greens.
Correct.
And I thought that the overall way that it was run was really very interesting.
But we did a state forum last year in a sort of similar format, but it was at the Alex and not Memo Hall. I think Memo Hall was actually a wonderful venue, very inviting.
It's much wider too.
Yes, it's and it's smaller in terms of numbers, but I think people felt there was a more intimate setting, and the way it was set up on the stage, and the what we want to do, instead of just having three or four people talking to each other, is to have a certain format and a bit of rigor. And that's why we picked three topics that were the, that are the topics that the people are the most interested in. There was a forum on climate, so we, there was no point to talk about climate again because we already had 3 hours about it. So we kept to three issues which we felt were of interest to people and different. And one was economy, one was human rights, immigration, refugees, and one was how can we put a bit of respect back in politics.
All about honesty and accountability.
Correct.
Yeah, so we're going to go out of this segment with just the opening statements from the three people who were on stage, and then we're going to come back to talk about this in more detail, especially about the work that John Daley did as the convener.
Correct.
That's fantastic. We'll be back after the break with more Shtick, more Serge, and talking politics.
I believe that we can do better than the politics of fear of Peter Dutton and Scott Morrison and Tony Abbott. Well, only in the last few hours it's been revealed that Andrew Hastie and Ian Goodenough has had meetings with Neil Erickson, the guy who has been accused of stalking a rabbi with a broad history of anti-Semitism and with close ties to Blair Cottrell and neo-Nazis in Australia. We can do better than the politics of fear, where only last week Scott Morrison decided to connect our humanitarian refugee intake with traffic and congestion problems in Melbourne and Sydney. It's appalling, and the politics of this country needs to be lifted.
We can and must transition to 100% renewable energy and embrace the opportunities that come with that. It's up to government to provide certainty, to provide incentives for new industry in our country, and the Greens have a roadmap that I'm so proud to be putting forward at this election. And we must return to a price on carbon. The only time we have seen a drop in emissions in this country was when the Greens worked constructively with the Labor Party to put a price on emissions.
My only agenda is to serve this community and to be an advocate for everyone in our nation's parliament. Whether you vote for me or not, if I am afforded that great privilege to serve as the first member for Macnamara, I will always be your voice. It's about you. It's about me standing up for you. I'm fighting for you and your families and for our community's future. Thank you.